Hello friends, as you are seeing on the screen, I will discuss the topic that is microwave engineering. Okay, in your final year it is there, in some college, some universities also in third year. I am going to deliver a series of lecture on this one, in this topic. Okay, so that you will get some knowledge about this topic. Okay, I believe you will get a lot of knowledge about this topic after going through my series of lectures. My name is Ramakrishna. You can contact me in future if you have any doubt regarding this topic, all these things. You can contact me with this mail ID at the rate geetam.edu. You can contact me. Okay. So, in today's class, what I am going to discuss? I am going to discuss little about introduction. Introduction to microwave engineering. Introduction to microwave engineering in the sense we will discuss about the from where it started until now, where it reached. Okay. How much we reached in this technology. I will discuss about those things started. And before, again, why you will read microwave engineering? That is another question mark. Okay, only for the sake of marks, score better in semester. Yeah? If that is your ultimate goal, then it is not useful for you a lot. Okay, although you will get a good job, that is another thing. Although you score good mark, you will score good job. But the thing is that reading this microwave engineering, anyone those who are interested in microwave engineering to build their future in technology, it must be much helpful for them, this topic. Okay, scope is the scope in this technology is much greater as you think. So reading this microwave is nothing but reading the invisible. Okay, invisible in the sense you cannot see it, you cannot see with your own eyes, you cannot touch it, okay, with your hand. But the thing is that you are using it in day-to-day life, in every home we are using it. It is strange. Okay, without knowingly we are using it. Okay, like God. Okay, God is, some are telling, where is God? God is nowhere. Still, when you are praying, you are getting the answer from the God, right? Exactly in the same manner, these microwaves are there. It is there. Since ancient time, it is there. But we came to know, in recent technology, we came to know in 1800th century. Mid of the 1800 century, we came to know about this technology and we reached into 2020, we reached with this technology in our hand. Okay, so it is really an amazing thing which you cannot see, which you cannot touch, still you are using it, isn't it? So, next, again someone will ask you, why you will read microwave? What is the need of microwave? Okay, why I will read microwave? That is another question. Without knowing why I am reading this topic and reading this topic, what is the use? So why you will read microwave? This microwave is nothing but it is a band of frequency. One band of frequency. Like everything in this universe is a game of frequency only. Okay, this creation is nothing but frequency only. Already it is proved. Big Bang theory. Already it is proved. This entire creation comes into existence because of frequency. Some mass is there, some strange frequency, suddenly some vibration taken place and all these galaxies, these star systems, planets, everything come into picture. Okay. So, out of this frequency, this microwave is a band of frequency. It is a band of frequency, bunch of frequency, which we are using for our development, for the betterment of humanity. Okay. So, again, as I told, without giving gratitude to those scientists, those persons who really gave this beautiful technology to us, it is really not worthy to read the topic. So, I am going to discuss first about those persons, those great personality who sacrificed their entire life's hard work to give you this technology, to give the next generation this technology. So, let us discuss about those great scientists, those engineers, those physicists, we'll discuss. The microwave term, the first microwave term, who coined the term microwave? Anyone? He is Nello Carrara. Nello Carrara, he is the person who gave this term, that your microwave, this term is given by him. Okay, he gave this term. 1932, he gave this term microwave. Nello Carrara. Okay. He is the person who you are observing on the screen. He gave this term microwave, the term. Okay, recently, means 1900 to 1993, his lifespan. In 1993, he departed from our planet. Okay. And basically, he is an Italian physicist. His topic of research is electromagnetic waves. Okay. Specifically, he is working on X-ray. He worked on X-ray as well as he is the pioneer of radar systems. Like all the war, anywhere war is there going on, radars are there. Not only war, in many field you are using it. But the thing is that you know only in war it is we are using this radar, right? So I told like that. So this is the pioneer of radar also. Okay. X-ray radar, he is the person who first time developed or working, first time means previously also some persons they worked, I will discuss. But the thing is that major work he is, has done above 1 gigahertz frequency, above 1 gigahertz, 10 to power 9. Okay, that frequency he, is work, he has worked in this one. And apart from him, beside him, there are many scientists also. Many engineers are also there. Similarly, another person is nothing but Oliver. You see on the screen, he is nothing but Oliver. He is a United Kingdom. He is a resident of United Kingdom. He is an electrical engineer, mathematician, as well as physics also. He measure, his major work is in developing that electromagnetic equations. Based on his equations only, you are studying now in electromagnetic, you studied that Maxwell's you studied. The Maxwell's, he has developed his work based on his work only. That is Oliver's work. Oliver, he is the person who gave the foundation for this electromagnetic waves, electromagnetic equations, based on which the Maxwell, he developed the building, those equations. Okay, so he is a person who gave lot of things like mathematical equations for electromagnetic waves. Next, similarly, another person already I told, he is nothing but he is Maxwell. Maxwell, he is also from United Kingdom only. In the same, they are in the same era, in 1832, around 1890, in those time. Okay. This Maxwell, he gave these equations, that is Maxwell's equations, popular equation, already four equations you know, right? One equation, that is two Coriolis equations, electric field, magnetic field, two divergence equations. Okay. This already you studied, no need to go about this thing. So, this equations, Maxwell's equations, Maxwell, he gave in 1861. He gave this equation 1861. Another person is also there who has given great contribution for this microwave. He is our Hertz. You are using, whenever you are writing any frequency, you are writing side by Hertz, HZ, capital H, small z. He is the person. Okay. So, he is the person who gave this Hertz. Unit, frequency unit, Hertz. Okay. He is a German physicist who proved the existence of electromagnetic waves, which is predicted by Maxwell. Remember, Maxwell only predicted. He didn't prove. Okay. Mathematical equations, he only predicted. Out of these predictions, he gave this like Kepler. What he gave? Kepler's planetary motion he gave. Mathematical equations he gave. That is also he gave, it is only predicted. There was no proof by that time. Okay, only they imagined, they calculated, they gave. Exactly in the same manner, Maxwell, he calculated, he told such kind of wave exist in nature. But the thing is that he didn't prove this kind of waves exist practically. He is the person, Hertz is the person who first time proved the existence of electromagnetic waves in 1888. 1879 Maxwell's passed. After just 8 or 9 years, 1888, Hertz proved this existence of microwaves. Practically, he demonstrated. Okay. Next person is very popular. That is Marconi. Okay. He is also a great contributor for this microwave engineering. Okay. This Marconi already, you all, even a small child, school child know, he developed the radio because of this great scientist only. Now we are using our FM radio or radio or television, all the transmissions which is going on because of him only. Okay. So, this Marconi, he developed the band. You know which band he developed? He worked in approximately 1.18 gigahertz. 1.18 gigahertz, whose wavelength is 25.4 some centimeter, 25.4 centimeter in that wavelength he worked, and he gave the L band. L band means many bands are there. The bands we will discuss, microwave bands we will discuss. L band right now also we are using in 2020, we are using that band for transmission to satellite. The satellites which are sending the signal to the earth surface, na, those signals which are sent by the satellite and reaching the earth, those are L band signals. Okay, we are using that one. Okay, so in 1895, he gave this microwave L band. In 2020, we are using that microwave, that band. Okay, for our purpose, for communication purpose. See, again, another person is also there, Fleming. You already studied Fleming's law. Okay, but very few know. His major contribution is microwave. In 1904, he discovered the vacuum tubes, which is the source of microwave generation. So using that vacuum tubes, you can generate the microwaves. This Fleming, he gave this. Okay, so let me show you. This you are observing on the screen, na? Those are nothing but those are vacuum tubes only. Okay. Again, these vacuum tubes nowadays we are not using it anyhow. Okay, or very less use we are using because of some advantage, disadvantage. But anyhow, that time generating microwave, it is great thing only. Okay, we are using this small device. Then later on, due to some disadvantage, we are going to discuss this in your topic when it will come. We are going to discuss in detail what are the advantages, disadvantages, construction, working principle, everything we will discuss in detail. Okay, so due to some disadvantages of this microwaves, later on another device came, that is your klystron tube. 1937 it is developed. This klystron tube we are observing on the screen, it is nothing but it is few feet high. Okay, but the thing is that in our lab, in microwave lab, you are going to see this tube only, klystron tube only, but it is only few centimeter length, few centimeter, the small size only. Okay, it is very small size. You are going to see, you are going to generate the microwave also. Okay, like previous time, the mobile was developed like, it is like a block of stone, very big box size. Now we are using very small, exactly in the same manner, this is the development that time. Next to klystron, magnetron is also developed. It is also source of this klystron, vacuum tube, magnetron, these all are, it is source of microwaves only. Okay, so this is also magnetron, it is also source. But this magnetron was developed, on the left side you are observing, that magnetron was developed in 1921. Okay, but right now also in 2020, see the Samsung magnetron. Okay, only the shape change, functionality remains same. We are using this magnetron still now. Okay, you see how much they have contributed for us. Okay, how much hard work they have done for us. Next one is your traveling wave tubes. Already I told, TWD, this is the shape you are observing. This is one of the device, TWD. Okay, traveling wave tubes. Now, this traveling wave tubes, it is developed by Australian scientist, that is Rudolph. Okay. He gave this traveling wave tube. Later on he shifted to England. In England he gave this, in England he done his higher education, then he has done job, and he gave this traveling wave tube there. 1943 this was developed, they gave this. Okay, and on the rightmost what you are observing, that is the first radar, that is the first major application of microwave, first major application in microwave, major application I am taking. Okay, these are the microwave generators. This traveling wave tube, klystron, then magnetron, then all those devices I discussed, those are microwave generators. They generate the frequency, that is your gigahertz frequency. But the first major application of microwave technology, it is nothing but application, is radar. And the first radar, it is developed by, it is again the Hirsch, already I told, he is also one of the contributor. Again, another scientist, Christian, is also there. They too developed this radar during World War II, Second World War. It is developed by German. They are the German scientists. They developed this radar. Okay. Then microwave engineering, microwave, that term is coined by, already I discussed, okay, that is Carrara. Again, microwave engineering, added the term engineering, it is added by the previous time, it is IEEE. Now also IEEE papers are there, now you are working. So in those times, in 1952 actually, in 1952, a group of MTT, MTT means Microwave Theory or Technique and Society, one society is there, they developed, they gave this term engineering, that is IRE, Institute of Radio Engineering. They gave this term microwave engineering and they gave the your syllabus. From there, 1952, your syllabus came. And 1952 onward, every student whoever joined in engineering, particularly in ECE, electrical, instrumentation, they are bound to read this microwave engineering. Okay. Without getting pass in this subject, they will not get the certificate. So this kind of thing. So microwave engineering, it is given in 1952. From there, in books they inserted, or this term microwave engineering, it came into picture. Okay. So this is all about your history. Okay. I discuss this thing because without giving gratitude to those entire scientist, team of scientists, it is really not good to go into the subject. Although it is optional for you, you may or may not go through this lecture. But anyhow, it is my duty to remember and give my prayer, give my gratitude to those engineers. Okay. Again, we will meet in next lecture. Thank you. Love you.